All right. So I'm gonna use this small brush, Catherine. Number 8. And I just wanna make some colors that are not what I get when I'm taking it right out of the tray.
And you're not wetting the paper tonight.
No. There's some yellow. This is a quinacridone red. Quinacridone is a dye that was developed by DuPont. They replaced another really popular red that used to fade. It became a real popular permanent color. Permanent red. So I'm doing this more carefully than I usually do.
I like that.
That purple is really the darkest color there so far. And I want to get this. Kind of gray. Little twist there. That is. Looks the same. Cerulean blue. Instead of just spreading it out evenly, I'm making these little strokes. It looks like patches or lines. So it's not trying to make it look like a sky, but just, I'm gonna put some purple on there too. Nope. And I'm going to get some more yellow. This was that lemon yellow that I said I don't use much. I'll show you what it looks like compared to that. This is the see the difference?
Yeah.
Kind of a lemon yellow is kind of a yellow that's leaning towards green, whereas the yellow ochre kind of leans toward orange. You see the green in that?
No, not from here. No, I can't see the green in it from here.
Yeah.
But I do know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's just
that shade in it.
You might not see the green, but that yellow is created because it has some green in it. You don't see the green, but it's what makes it be that color.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to put some green in this blue. So this is a blue-green, and you don't see the blue in it, but I got it by mixing some blue and some lighter green. And I guess if you play with making colors that way, you're more able to see it as having blue in it, because you remember that's how you made it. Oh, I splashed all over my painting.
Yeah. I really like watching the colors change when you mix paints in your palette.
Yeah. I don't pay attention to it while I'm painting, but I know what you mean. You can sort of luxuriate in it.
Mm-hmm.
Where are you seeing that happening, Kevin?
On your palette, where you're mixing the paint before you.
And tell me again what you're seeing.
What?
What is it that you're seeing? Oh, you're seeing me mixing the colors.
Right.
I thought you were talking about how the colors mix themselves or bleed into one another.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to put some yellow ochre in this. And it's the only thing that's still wet. Get my brush dry. So these things have a darkness to them that makes them stand out. And over here, it's just kind of bland. And so I'm going to put some dark characters over there, like I do. Can you see the blue and the brown in that together? So I got some of this and some of this.
Mm-hmm.
So both of those colors are on the brush.
Mm-hmm.
That didn't stay on there. Put some rocks in, or little worms. Something needs to happen in there. Green and red. That just looks like it's nothing going on there.
Well, when you puff on it, they're gonna.
Yeah, these things will puff out. Let's see what happens. Now, they'll make something go on up there. Put this tape around my straw so I don't go putting my mouth on the dirty end.
Oh, yeah.
Too dry.
Your camera just went off, Martin.
Low battery.
Back.
Yeah. I need to plug it in, Catherine. Hold on. Okay. Can you see there now?
Yeah. But you need to pull your paints down a little bit. That's perfect, yeah. What color is that?
Violet. There, took care of that.
Yeah.
You better step back a little, Kevin.
Love it.
That cheered it up a little bit.
Yeah. Once the yellow, it's nice too.
Yeah, no, that's a good idea.
Nice. What do you think? I'm trying to get you to talk.
Oh, what do I think? Yeah.
Get the camera back on you.
Yeah. So, yeah, that made that purple line a little more interesting.
Yeah, it did.
Now I'm going to do something with that. With some red. There. Okay.
perfect. I really like your, it looks like a fence to me at the top.
Oh yeah, I forgot all about that.
It really is nice.
Do this.
That's very good right there.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Put your camera down a little bit, just a tad. Yeah, that's good.
Mm-hmm. You're seeing the glare on the table, aren't you?
I'm not seeing it. Oh, yeah, on the table, but not on the print. No.
All right. Well, it ended up being complicated again, wasn't
it? You're in a complicated phase.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, if you are, you are.
You're right. Thanks for reminding me. I do get critical of myself, and it's hard just to let things be and let, yeah. This is what I did and it's okay.
Yeah, it's not fun anymore if you do that.
You're right.
In the upper right-hand corner, the brown figure. It's in a little bit to the picture. It's brown. It's in the upper right.
Right here?
Over to the left a bit.
Right here?
No, it's lighter than that. It's in the yellow area.
This?
That, yeah. That looks like mm-hmm. a golfer to me, swinging his golf club.
It's a golf. Yeah, somebody playing golf. It's Donald Trump.
It looks like a garden again.
Down here looks like a garden.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to go, Martin.
What?
I'm gonna have to go.
Okay, Kevin. Well, thanks for our talk and for your watching me paint.
Yep. Yeah, thank you.
Have a good evening.